My name's Philippa Woodward. I'm from Dorset County Council. My role at Dorset County Council is participation lead, focusing on post 16. So it's really important for me to come to events like today so that I can look at the opportunities that are out there for young people and we can look at trying to bridge that gap. It's really important that we focus on all areas for young people in terms of the curriculum and in terms of the demographic makeup of those young people. So it's been really interesting for me today to talk to teachers, to talk to employers, and to look at the research that people are doing around STEM and predominantly engineering with an engineering focus.
My name's Hannah and I work for Curtis Wright in the Avionics and Electronics department. I gave a presentation today on women in engineering. I think engineering is interesting for women and for men because it's so diverse, there's so many different branches of it and everything that we have around us is engineered in some sort of way. You don't need to sort of limit yourself to thinking, oh, it's going to be dirty, it's going to be like grimy. There's lots of different things out there that are engineered and it's actually a very clean process. I think it's one industry that some people are very blind about. Okay, so I studied my BTEC level 3 here, and then I got my apprenticeship, and now I'm studying my HNC here at Bournemouth and Poole College. In the long term, I plan to go to Southampton University and study my degree, and my top goal is to eventually become a professor.
Hi, my name is Anna Harpengist. I am the second in department, so deputy head of department in TED, Technology, Engineering and Design at the Bourne Academy, which I love working at. I've been invited here today. I'm very, very glad to be here again, another great conference. I've been speaking today about engineering and about how we can engage our young people in engineering, what we can do to inspire the engineers of the future. I'm really lucky to work with great young people. They inspire me, to be honest. We need to get them into engineering as soon as possible. We need to give them opportunities like work experience. We need to put them in the workplace. We need to allow them to expand on the skills that they're already developing in schools. So we've got some great projects that we run at the Academy. We need to be able to offer opportunities like extracurricular clubs where they can develop the skills they've already learned. And most importantly, they need to be able to see engineering in action. They need to be able to see men, they need to be able to see women in engineering, enjoying it, enjoying all aspects of it, and just communicating to them that this is a great area to work in, amazing opportunities, especially for employment in this area. And we just need everybody's help. We need.
Okay, so I'm Sue Raxter and I'm head of HR for Ultra Electronics Energy. And I've come here today to the CPD Day for Engineering Focus to talk about business approach to engagement with schools and how we can partner businesses in a more commercial way with schools and their talent pipeline joined up with ours. So one thing I wanted to get across today is how we as Ultra have had a rethink on our approach to the schools engagement, more of a strategic viewpoint on that now. It doesn't mean to say we won't work with schools as and when we can, but it eliminates that more scattergun approach where you're hoping you hit the right areas and link in with the right people. From our new approach, we're looking at, for example, a 3 to 5 year engagement plan with schools where we select 3 secondary schools, a couple of primary schools, and we create a lasting partnership with them where we look at their talent pipeline, their STEM subject areas, and where we can collaborate on skills, knowledge, events, STEM initiatives that bring not just a return on investment to the school, but the student and to the business. So our ultimate aim with the strategic approach is to have some metrics measurement of our return on investment, not just for us, but for the schools, and feed that really, really important talent pipeline into our businesses. Or if those students don't come into our businesses, ensure that they stay in a STEM career mindset and go into local businesses and create those sustainable programs for the future. Thank you.